M30. This is our second lesson in acids and bases. This is predicting Bronsted Lowry reactions. Today we're going to look at the theory and rules behind Bronsted Lowry acid base reactions. Then we'll move on to the steps in how to predict acid base reactions, and we'll have 5 examples today. So our guiding question for today's lesson: when multiple substances are placed in a container, the collision reaction theory states that all of the species have the potential to collide and react. How do we know which ones will actually react and form new products? Consider the following. The species that is most willing to lose a proton is likely to do so. That would be your strongest acid. And the species that is most able and willing to accept a proton will do so. That would be your strongest base. If a lesser acceptor takes the free proton first, it will eventually transfer the proton to the stronger acceptor over time. We need to look for the strongest acid, which would be our donor, and the strongest base, which will be our acceptor. And these will be the species in the reaction. For these types of reactions, we are only going to assume the transfer of one proton or hydrogen. Predicting Bronsted-Lowry reactions. Step number one, we have to make a list of all of the species available to react. Aqueous solutions will always include water, so list water as a species. Strong acids will always ionize 100% in water. So when we list strong acids, we list them as H3O plus and their anion. Weak acids do not ionize. So when we list weak acids, we list them as they appear. We will dissociate any soluble ionic compounds and list their ions. If we have an insoluble ionic compound, we'll leave the compound as it appears. Finally, metal ions do nothing, and they are just spectators in Bronsted-Lowry reactions. Step number two. Using our data booklet, from the list of species in step one, we have to identify and label the strongest acid and the strongest base. These will be your reactants in the acid-base reaction. Once we have our reactants, we can move on to step three and transfer the proton from the acid to the base to form the products and complete the reaction. We can also predict the extent of the reaction. So are the products or reactants favored in the equilibrium? So when doing this, we have to refer to our strengths of acids and bases table in the Chem 30 data booklet, and we have to compare the two reactants. If the acid is vertically higher than the base on our data table, then we are going to assume that the reaction is product favored, meaning the products will be greater than 50%. Again, comparing the reactants. If the base is vertically higher on the table, then our acid, then we are going to assume the reaction and the equilibrium is reactant favored, meaning the products form less than 50%. Example number one, predict the acid-base reaction that occurs when methanoic acid is mixed with sodium hydrogen sulfide. Are the reactants or products favored? Pause the video and attempt this example. We're back. Step number one, list all of the species available to react. First up, we have methanoic acid. This is a weak acid, so we list it as it appears, HCOOH. Next is sodium hydrogen sulfide. This is an ionic compound, so we dissociate it and list its ions, Na+, HS-. We also always have water available as a species. We have to label all of the species as either an acid or a base or both. And from our list of species, we have to choose our strongest acid and our strongest base. That brings us to our relative strengths of acids and bases table. First, we have to find our strongest acid. And remember, the strongest acids are at the top of the table. So we'll start at the top and move downwards. Our strongest acid is going to be methanoic acid. Now we have to find our strongest base. And strongest bases are at the bottom of the table. So we're going to start at the bottom and move upwards. And we can see that our strongest base is HS-. It has been determined that our strongest acid is HCOOH and our strongest base is HS-. These will be the reactants in our equation. So we have our two reactants. We are going to transfer a hydrogen from the acid to the base, resulting in the products H2S and HCOO-. To determine the extent of the reaction, we have to compare the acid and the base in the reactants and determine which one is higher on the table. When comparing the two reactants, it is clear to see that our acid is higher on the table than the base. Since the acid is above the base on our table, we are going to assume this is product favored, and the products will be greater than 50%. Example number two. Predict the acid-base reaction when ammonia is mixed with hydrochloric acid. Are the reactants or products favored? Pause the video and attempt this example. Step number one, list all of the species available to react. So we have ammonia. We also have hydrochloric acid, which is a strong acid. So it will ionize and we will list it as H3O+ and its anion Cl-. And again, we always have H2O available. We are going to label all of the species as acids or bases or both and choose our strongest acid and our strongest base. Our strongest acid is H3O+ and our strongest base is NH3. These will be the reactants in our chemical equation. We then transfer a hydrogen from the acid to the base, resulting in the products H2O and NH4+. To determine the extent of the reaction, we have to compare the reactants, and it is determined that the acid is higher on our table of strengths of acids and bases compared to the base. Therefore, this will be product favored. Example number three, given the following reaction, determine which species is the acid, which species is the base, and connect them to their conjugate acid and base. Pause the video and attempt this example. Okay, so when we look at our chemical equation, let's first take a look at HSO4-. And let's look for SO4- on the product side. And it's right here. So I can tell that HSO4- has lost a hydrogen. Therefore, it's an acid. HCOO- on the other side of the table has gained a hydrogen. So HCOO- is a base. Resulting in our answer, we have our acid and our base, and now we have gained hydrogen, so HCOOH is now my conjugate acid, and SO42- is now my conjugate base. And we have connected the conjugate acid and base pairs. Example number four, vinegar and baking soda are added to recipes to produce baked products with light, fluffy textures. What is the net ionic equation for this reaction? In other words, what is the Bronsted Lowry reaction? Pause the video and attempt this example. Okay, so we have listed all of our species. CH3COOH is a weak acid, so we list it as it appears. NaHCO3 is an ionic compound, so we have dissociated into its ions. And we also have, again, H2O available as a species. So we have already determined that our strongest acid is CH3COOH, and our strongest base is HCO3-. These will be the two reactants in our chemical equation. So now we are going to transfer hydrogen from the acid to the base, resulting in our products CH3COO- and H2CO3. H2CO3 is interesting because if you look in our data booklet, it is also represented as CO2 gas and H2O liquid. So be wary of this in case you see this in a future question. The same can also be said for sulfurous acid, H2SO3. It can also be represented as SO2 and H2O. And to our last example, number five, a student prepares a 0.100 moles per liter solution of sodium dihydrogen borate with a Ka value of 1.0 times 10 to the negative 13. Determine the Bronsted-Lowry acid-base reaction that takes place when the solution is mixed with another solution containing potassium hydrogen carbonate. So we have to list all of our species and label them as either acids or bases. We are going to exclude metal ions, and we are going to determine that our strongest acid is HCO3- and our strongest base is HBO3-. HBO3 minus is not on our table of strengths of acids and bases. So we have to compare the Ka value to the listed Ka values in the table. HBO3 minus has a Ka value of 1.0 times 10 to the negative 13th. If we input this into our table, it is going to fall approximately right here in the table. So let's just consider that. So now to find our strongest acid, we're going to start at the top and we're going to move downwards until we see HCO3 minus. That is our strongest acid. Now to find our strongest base, we start at the bottom. And remember, HBO3 minus fell right in this location. So that would become our strongest base. Now we are going to take our strongest acid and our strongest base. These will be our reactants. And we are going to write our chemical equation. We are going to transfer a hydrogen from the strongest acid to the strongest base, resulting in the products H2BO3 and CO3 2 minus. This is going to be a product favored equilibrium. Therefore, the products are going to be greater than 50%. That is all for today's lesson. Moving forward, we are going to test our Bronsted Lowry reactions in a laboratory.